G'day guys, Rubber Kitty here. Oh, what a weekend. Met some new people, caught up with some people that I just met, got to know them a bit better, met some people that I've known for a while, caught up with them. Busy, busy. Love talking to people. Love looking at their perspective and stuff. Anyways, okay. What are you going to do with what you've got? A lot of people that actually have a lot and they don't realise it and they just don't do anything with it. I don't know whether it's a thing these days of, you know, I need more, need faster, need flashier, keeping up with the Joneses sort of a thing. Kind of like keeping up with the Sims, really. But I think too many people don't really appreciate what they've got and they don't know how to utilize what they've got, whether it's material or whether it's things like friends, family, relationships, or realize the skills and talents that they actually have. A lot of people are very talented, a lot of people are very skillful, a lot of people have a lot of knowledge and a lot of nous, and they don't use it a lot. I don't know why that is, but me, sometimes I get caught up in things and I kind of go, oh, you know, or I actually forget, or I don't realize that I actually have a skill or talent in that particular area, which is why it's always good to sometimes check in with your mates or talk to new people, and then you kind of realize, hey, look, here's something else that I have in my tool of tricks, or my bag of tricks, I should say. So, example, there's a mate of mine who has like fruit trees. We just recently got given a whole lot of citrus stuff, and I'm still like lying there and I'm looking at him going, well, there's only so many things we can do with citrus, is there? Or is there some things more I can do? So I decided to make a cheesecake and I made it, and I didn't put as much sugar in it as I think most people probably would have liked. So it ended up being a really, really tarty cheesecake. A bit sour, but offset with a nice, not so sour gelatin sort of lemony layer and a slightly sweeter biscuity base. I probably could have put more sugar and stuff like that in, but you know, experimenting to see what it would make and how it would taste, and you know, why not? But thing is, what are you going to do with what you've got? I mean, honestly, looking at what you've got, and the thing is, there's some things that you have that other people don't have, and you're very fortunate to have those things, but you're not utilizing those things to its fullest extent. Now, that can be in anything. It can be, like as I said, it could be material things, it could be your skills, your knowledge, your experience, your friends. They're not saying like, you know, aggressively use your friends, but using their knowledge, skills and experience to help you, or to evolve, or to learn, or you know, you just don't know sometimes what you have in order to use it to its fullest extent. But what you do have, don't just use them in the usual ways. Think a little outside the box. You know, one of the things that's really popular in the BDSM lifestyle is kinkifying things. I have a little thing where sometimes I'll kinkify songs just because I kind of feel a bit cheeky at the time. I'm listening to it and I go, hey, I could swap those lyrics out and, you know, make someone a little bit happier, I guess. I mean, that's a kind of a skill thing that I have. But it's something they call pervertibles. Basically taking something every day and using it for something that's completely unexpected to do with a kink or something. It's what they call a pervertible. And that's an example of taking something that you have and thinking of a different way to use it. Not always in the typical thing. This is, I guess, why I'm not so big on labels. Labels are awesome for guidance, for helping to communicate ideas and concepts, but when it applies to real life situations, you need to be a bit more flexible, think outside the box, and think a different way. Think of how it can be applied, think of all the angles, because life is very much more than 3D or 4D. Life is non-linear, life is around you, and life is an adventure. So, okay, I've rambled on enough, I think, about what you have and what are you going to do with what you've got. Think about what you've got, whether it's your determination to get something done, whether it's, you know, your knowledge of something, whether it's something physical that you have that you can apply, what best use is it? If you're not going to use it, you might lose it as like a skill. Or if it's something that you really don't not going to use, that's a physical material thing, think of someone who might want to use it or who will use it to best effect. And that is also something that's good, because then you're allowing other people or getting people the opportunity to actually grow more and use something. And who knows, later on they might go, hey dude, here's something that you could use. And you go, oh awesome, I didn't know that I needed that, but you know what, I'm going to use that to its best effect. So what do you have? What do you use it for? What other things can you use it for? Not just material. Look inside yourself, look around you. There's heaps of things that you could use. You could use alternatively, and use to great effect. If not, can somebody else use it? That's useful. Okay, anyway, lovely sunshine. Still a bit nippy in the morning, but lovely sun. And starting to get a bit warmer. So that'll be interesting in latex. It'll be soon coming up to my third year. It's been over 2.5 years since I've been in latex every day, guys. Oh, it's been a journey. Anyways, I'll see you guys later. Love yous, bye.